Hello, walkers, and welcome to Alaska. Welcome to the Harding Icefield in Kenai Glacier National Park. I think that's where we are. We are at 3,500 feet above elevation. It's about 3 p.m. early September. I have no idea what the temperature is because there's no Celsius up here, obviously. We spent about 4 hours hiking from way down there. Pretty steep, 4 miles, 3,000, 3,500, 3,300 feet of elevation gain. And we're near Seward, I guess. This is Exit Glacier to the right, named apparently, we were told, because when the explorers were coming off the ice field, that was how they came off, along this glacier. Of course, back then, it went down another mile or so. It's retreated quite a ways. So we are going to make our way, actually I'm going to go this way, make our way back down for about an hour. I'm not going to film the whole way probably because we get into a bunch of alders and it gets, film wise, it's not as exciting. And hopefully we will not fall too many times. I would guess right now, the temperature coming off the ice, it's probably 45 degrees-ish Fahrenheit. Don't know what that is in Celsius. Just off the top of my head. And further away from the glacier, probably bumps up to 60, but we have had beautiful weather. Oh my gosh, this place is known for having a lot of rain. We kind of expected to have rain. We dressed for rain, brought our rain gear, but we haven't had any rain. It's been wonderful, wonderful day to hike up here. It took us about 4 hours, I think I said. And I'm sorry, let me just make sure I get this thing pointed the right direction. My name is Henry. I will be your proxy walker today here in Kenai, your virtual travel guide. For guide's probably a generous term because I'm new here myself and these are walks tend to be explorations. I'm not going to talk as much as I normally do, even though I recently had a comment which was interesting that said he, on the nature hikes, he liked the talking because it makes him, keeps him distracted a little bit, which I get. So we're going to turn you around here. And I will call out a few things if I see him, but otherwise, or if I think of him, but otherwise, I think I'm just going to walk. Hope that's okay. Oh, I guess I did want to say, if you haven't subscribed yet, please do so. It helps me out a lot with Google and YouTube ranking. Comment, I love getting your comments, love interacting with you guys. I mentioned someone's comment earlier. He's a recent commenter and it's given me a lot of great feedback, a lot of interesting comments. And I try to reply to them all the ones that Google and YouTube let through. Oh, and like if you like the video. Some really dramatic scenery up here. It's absolutely beautiful. You can see the glacier, the crevasses down there. There was a helicopter landed down there earlier. Look at this. Pan back to show you. A surprising number of people have taken this trail all the way up here. And it's a bit of a grind. So kudos to them. And heck, kudos to us, traveling Mel and the boys came up with me. And we're gonna be making an Alaska video or two. And so keep an eye out on that channel. Hi there.
How are you going?
Hi. Here's an emergency hut. It's up here in case it gets stormy while you're up here. Given the number of people up here, I don't think it could hold them all, though. Down at the bottom, there is a short paved trail to the bottom of Exit Glacier, if you don't want to hike all the way up here. And if you don't want to hike all the way up to this point, there's several different lookout areas that give you amazing views of the glacier. Hi there.
Sorry.
No, you're fine.
If I got you on video.
The river valley down there, they call the washout plain. I heard one of the guides that we passed on the way up, she was saying that never actually gets to full, that riverbed never fills all the way across like most riverbeds. It just meanders and deposits the sediment that's in the meltwater over time, over millennia. You get little ponds here. Meltwater ponds, and then creeks too, running down. Look at the color of that algae or the moss. How bright green that is. Life will find a way. To quote a movie. Warming up once you get out of that glacial wind. Hi there. You can see the rocks here. I'm going to show you that a little bit. It's broken up, flat stuff. Pretty interesting. If you like rocks, geology is pretty cool. I don't know about cool, but it's not the cool kids wouldn't do it, but I think it's cool. Little meltwater creek here. Earlier, when we get down here, we saw a little marmot, so maybe we'll still be there munching on all the little plants it can find. Pretty cool ravine here too. Now the marmot must have been further down. Now this stuff is super grainy, super slippery, at least it was, so hopefully I don't bite it here. You can see how Made it. Look at all those green on the mountainsides too. Sorry, I just want to look back and see what it looks like. You can just kind of see the hut to the left of that snow. Looked a lot further when we were coming up. So I think the last walks I did were in Anchorage, which is an interesting town. But this is what we came to Alaska for. This kind of thing, this wildness, this remoteness, dramatic scenery. Looking forward to seeing more of it. Man, we lucked out on the weather too. Lakes, little ponds, tarn. I have to huff and puff a little bit on the way up this. As we drop down, we'll get into more plant life, get into some kind of open meadows. Then you start to get into little copses of alder. Then you get into the thick alder. And then the full-on forest down low. It's an interesting progression, forest succession. I'll show you what these little plants look like. Over here. Super vibrant colors. Then you got these over here, the leafy ones. Interesting stuff. Have these orange flags occasionally to mark the path. Hi there.
How's it going?
Good, thanks.
Good.
Look at that view. We're not that many miles from the ocean. 10 miles maybe, 15? Icefield again. Hi there. This is where we saw the marmot. There's the upstream version. He was literally right there against the creek. Didn't bother him that we were here at all. A guy said it was a hoary marmot. And we normally down the 48, I think, as they say up here, get a lot of yellow-bellied marmots. Whoops. the blue and that ice. It's a lot easier going down than it did up. Look at these guys too. This plant, little seed head there, flower, a bunch of those. The plants change, of course, as we go lower. Each find their own little niche, different elevations, different microclimates. Look at these red beels. No idea what these are. If you know, please put the timestamp and the flower name or the plant name, I'd love to know. I did download this app, I think it's called Picture This AI, and it's supposed to be able to identify these plants just from a photo, but you have to have cell service, and obviously we don't have that up here. I've taken some pictures, and I'm gonna try and get those identified later. You can hear the water falling on the far side of the valley. At least I can. Hopefully you guys can. Just a quick turn around to show you where we came from. Up and to the right of that ridge. That wind that's coming up is kind of warm. I may have to take a break in a bit and take off the jacket. We'll see. But look how tall this grass has gotten all of a sudden. As we've lost just 100 feet or so of elevation. And it's, you know, it's no longer 8 inches. It's now 18, 24 inches. It smells good. These guys, these little flowers. So you can see a promontory kind of down there. We stop for a break down there. It's a beautiful view. And you look back this way and this trail doesn't look that steep. And then you start to climb. And it seems a lot, here's some fireweed, I think. Seems a lot steeper coming up. I'm gonna pull over and let these folks pass. Or maybe they're gonna let me pass, I guess. Thank you. Smell some mint up here, something similar to it anyway. So it's September and these colors, these plants are starting to change. lose their green, go to orange and yellows. You got some fireweed up there. So vibrant. Wow. Got some down here on the right. I don't know if you can see it, but just up there is a little purple flower. I think it's lupin, maybe. These folks have trekking poles, and I wish I had some, although I got to carry the camera. This is rough on the quads. I'll try to remember to check the elevation again when we stop this walk, probably at this promontory down here, and let you know that the change. Excuse me. Thanks. Welcome. Reminds me a bit of Finisterre walk from Switzerland. Check that out if you haven't. Yeah, there we go. Oh, look, here's some lupin. I think that's lupin. Can you see it? Beautiful flower. Maybe it's something else. Look how crazy it is out here. I think I'd go to the right. Look at this fuzzy seed pods down here. It's like fur or feathers. Interesting. Cool. Just to the right of that notch, see people coming down the trail that we've come down. think I'm supposed to go this way. Down these steps. Ooh, those are big steps. They're nice going up. They're a little rough coming down. Go off to the left here. A little tree trying to make its way in the world, way up high here. Good luck with that. Another one on the ridge there. Oh, the light's getting nice. Somebody relaxing, enjoying the view. I got off the trail and I want to minimize my impact here, so I'm going to go on the mud. Alrighty. We are at, according to my app, about 2,460 feet here, and I think we're going to call this one. Thanks for joining us. I hope you will subscribe, comment, all that fun stuff. Mainly come back next time. Not sure where that's going to be, but it's going to be in Alaska, so check us out. We'll see you soon. Until then, from Kenai and Exit Glacier, Alaska, keep on steppin'.